So this is just going to be a short video that looks at how to do some basics on a Trezor Model T. And that is how to wipe the device if you forget your PIN, how to do a seed verification, that is a dry run recovery, and also how to restore an existing seed phrase onto the device. These are just some basic things that will give you confidence to do these things yourself when you need to do that, and also to help you to know what the legitimate process looks like so you're better able to spot a scam. The actual process for entering the seed words into the device is the same for both dry run recovery and for the actual recovery, so I'll just be quickly showing you how to initiate both processes and then just doing a quick run through of what that actually looks like. And if you haven't already done so, hit subscribe, and that way you can stay in the loop about content I make to help you stay safe in the crazy and often hostile environment that is cryptocurrency. So we've got the Trezor, and we'll just quickly run through the factory reset procedure. So basically how you do that is you want to swipe over the screen as you plug it in. And the timing on this can be a bit tricky, but I'll just show you how I do it here. So you basically just, I put it halfway in, and then just swipe as I plug, and there you go. So basically it's asking now, do we want to connect to the host? That means connect to the computer, and we'll say yes. And if you look over here on the Trezor wallet, you can see now it has detected it. And what we want to say here is factory reset the device, because I forgot the PIN, and we'll just say yes. So we can just unplug the device. And now if we plug it back in, it's like we have a brand new Trezor. So if you reset your Trezor T, you are gonna have to reinstall the firmware. So basically the process of recovering a new seed when you plug it in is just gonna be you plug the Trezor in, and then when presented with this option, you're just gonna say recover wallet. And unlike the Trezor 1, this recovery happens entirely on the Trezor. Likewise, the entering of passphrases happens on the Trezor T as well. And the good thing is if you get any of this stuff wrong, you can always change it later. So we're going to say yes, we want to recover the wallet. If you already set up your Trezor and you just want to make sure that the copy of your seed you have is actually what's in there, maybe you've got multiple seeds, maybe you just want to double check that it's right, you go into the Trezor wallet, you hit test, and then you just go onto advanced, and then you will say, I want to check the recovery seed. And basically, it gives some instructions here. And again, on the Trezor T, all of this happens on device, and the process is identical to setting up a new device from scratch, except you'll be prompted to put in your PIN. So just for the sake of speed, the seed phrase that I use in all my demo videos is this one here. It's only 12 words. So we're just going to say it is a 12 word seed. And now we enter it. So I've seen a number of people get confused with how this actually works on the Trezor. You'll notice each of them has a couple of letters on them, and you just sort of hit that several times in a row to get through the letters. So hit it once for M, twice for N, and three times for O. So we'll just show you that now. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2. And there's ocean. That's our first word. So we can say tick. You'll notice when you are using the same letter twice, you have to wait for the little cursor to move over. So you can actually just type in the first four letters and then hit this touchscreen thing up here, and that'll get you the full word. And then once you finish entering your seed, this is the message you are looking for. So it says the entered recovery seed is valid and matches the one in the device. Now, it will tell you if the seed is valid and doesn't match the one in the device. And also, if at any point when you're trying to enter in your seed, you encounter a word that is not available to select in the Trezor, at that point you probably should really double check the BIP39 word list and make sure the word you have is actually on there, because I have seen instances where people have made a typo transcribing their seed and then get all upset because the word can't be found when they're going to restore it in here. But fortunately, if you do have a word that you've transcribed that's not part of the BIP39 word list, that actually makes recovering it using something like BTC Recover a lot easier. So there you go, that's how you verify your seed, or dry run recovery as it's called on the Trezor website, and also how you restore an existing seed onto the device. The process is the same, and again, anything at all that is asking you to enter this seed anywhere other than on your Trezor itself is a scam, and you can just know immediately to avoid that. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.